been looking at these for quite some time, just had never found one in Australia. And they come to the UK, although someone else said that they're a JDM, Japanese domestic market, so I'm not really sure. But what I am sure of and what I can tell you is that the aesthetics on this watch is quite amazing. This was a deceased estate. I was very lucky to get this. It's in the sunlight, around the middle of the dial, you can see the battery. You can't see it at the moment because there's no sunlight, but when the sun's on it, you can actually see the battery, the Eco-Drive battery, right in the middle of the dial. But anyway, it's 40-41, I'm not quite sure, I haven't got my calipers, but they're 40, some people say 40, some people say 41, side to side, with a height of 11 mil only, so they're very thin, and a lug width of 20 mil, and lug to lug is 47, so they're right in that sweet spot of 47 lug to lug, which means anyone can really wear it, even with a 6.5 inch wrist. But I'm here to tell you now, this watch is worth the wait. It has really surprised me. There's another one online with a strap. I've actually just bought that today. I'm waiting for the fellow to come back from overseas. He's gonna ship it off to me. It's got the Kevlar, what they call a Kevlar strap. I'm not real keen on that, but I've brought it as a backup watch head to put on this bracelet if anything happens to this one. But sometimes the cells do go. Anyway, this is a used condition. It's in good used condition. I just took the pin out of the clasp. It's got the milled out clasp on it. There's a few scrapes on it, but not too many. A grandfather owned it apparently. And the granddaughter sold it to me. I love these Eco-Drives. They're a bit of a throwaway watch, so to speak, but they the accuracy is what I like about them. Pardon the photography here. I'm running it on an iPhone, so. But no, it's truly, the aesthetics of this is amazing. There's two Rolexes that this looks very similar to, the Explorer, and there's another Rolex, a dead set ringer. There is a fellow online that reckons the aesthetics of this is better than his Rolex. It's a big statement. I'm here to tell you that the quality of this watch is outstanding. I've got some expensive pieces, and this thing, honestly, it is as good, if not better, than a lot of watches that I have that are up to like $6,000. It's a bit Seiko-ish, this band, this bracelet, but it's just a beautiful watch. It really is. It wears really well. You don't even know you've got it on your wrist. It has the shiny pieces just around the bezel, and then down here where the battery is. They're the pins are not screw, unfortunately, for the links. They're not screw in. They're just straight, not collar pins, whatever they're called. They're just a straight split pin. I just can't believe the quality in this thing. It's quite amazing, really, for the price of them. They weren't expensive new. They do come in a titanium version with sword hands, which is quite nice also. But very, very legible. So I believe the new ones have got what they call a monoblock case. They don't have a case back, they have a monoblock on the casing. But all jokes aside, this thing is insane. I love it. I like it that good, I'm buying a second one. I bought a second one, waiting for it to arrive. There's the bracelet, nice quality bracelet. What's it say here? Citizen stainless steel or something. a bit wobbly on the old video. Anyway, that's it. That's the Citizen BM-6400, I think is the model number. If you're able to get one, hold of one of these, grab it, because the quality on them is quite amazing. You won't be sorry. It's an insane watch, honestly. Very, very good watch.